What does positive train control do?
Positive train control is an idea, Jake, that's been around for about 25 years. And putting it in place has not just been a budget issue, it has also been a technological issue, because you're talking about building a matrix of information around every train out there. It starts with GPS, satellite systems, to tell the engineer precisely where he is at all times and to tell other trains where his train is. Second element, basically ground stations that are alongside the tracks to tell them about switch positions, where there might be work crews, other things to be concerned about, and then ground control stations that put all that information together to make sure he knows where there are bends in the road, where there might be a trail, overpass, anything like that. And it all comes out in a simple readout for the engineer that tells him at any given moment how fast he can afford to be going and when he has to start braking. And if he gets too close to any type of hazard out there, the computers from this big matrix just take over and they automatically slow that train down and even make it stop if necessary so we don't have a catastrophe, Jake.
Now, Tom, the system costs about $14 billion to get into place and then $900 million each year to maintain. What would we get for that money? What does it buy?
What we would hope to get from all of that, and what congressional researchers believe we would get, is no more train-to-train collisions like we've seen before. We wouldn't see switching errors where somebody just doesn't realize they're being shunted off onto a different track where an accident might occur. You wouldn't see trains running up on work crews. And importantly, you would not see what we just saw a couple of days ago, which is a train coming too fast into a turn because the computer wouldn't let any of this happen. But this is important. In terms of train collisions and derailments, this would stop 2% of them, 2%. An important 2%, but many more would go on, and it would do nothing to deal with people and cars getting onto the tracks, which actually kill hundreds of people every year.